today we're going to be learning about bones. What are they? What are they made of? Are they just a delicious treat for your dog, or are they more? I'm Mary Ellen the Body Dog. Welcome to my Clinic of Marvels. Bones, that's our topic for today. What are they? What do they do? Okay, so I'm sure we all know what they are generally, right? They're these solid white things, and when you put them together, they make a scary looking creature.
Oi, I resent that representation.
Okay, Jack, I get it.
Come on, you know I'm not scary. I wouldn't hurt a fly. I can't even go to scary movies on my own. I just don't have the guts.
Okay, bad jokes aside, let's get back to bones. Why exactly are they important to our anatomy? Like, aside from just sitting there, what do they actually do? Do they do anything? Let's start with the basics. Our bodies are made up of lots of different things, but we are actually up to 60% water. So we really need something sturdy to give us a stable structure. Otherwise, we'd resemble a blob. This heart framework also helps to support weight, like our sturdy leg bones that carry us around wherever we want to go. Let's have a think about that movement for a moment. If our muscles didn't have something to attach to, how would we move? They would contract, but not very much would happen. So our bones don't just keep us upright, they act as levers for our muscles to create movement. Muscles and bones make a pretty good team.
What? Oh, just like me and you, Marianne. We make a great team. You've got all the muscles, and I've got all the brains. Bones.
Jack has been trying to convince me that he should be a bigger part of my videos because he might be helpful. You're too scared to come out of your room. How on earth are you going to be in my videos?
Yeah, okay, I'm working on it. Alright, today's the day I'm gonna do it. I'm coming out. Just a bit of deep breathing, that's all I need. Okay. Well, look, I think we've made great progress today. How about we make something?
Anatomy, arts, and crafts.
Okay, here we are in the craft corner because today we're making something a little bit messy. Today we're making Play-Doh. And I know what you're all thinking. You think you are too old for Play-Doh. Well, you're not too old for Play-Doh because Play-Doh is good for you. Not good to eat. Please do not eat Play-Doh. It's good for your soul. Just like coloring, drawing, painting, creating. Creating is good for your brain and it's good for your spirit. So today we're gonna create Play-Doh and we're gonna use our Play-Doh to create something else. Here's what you're gonna need to make your Play-Doh. 2 cups of plain flour, 3/4 of a cup of salt, 4 teaspoons of cream of tartar, 2 tablespoons of vegetable oil, some food coloring, I've got lots of colors to choose from here, and 2 cups of lukewarm water. Oh, and the other thing that you can use, so this is optional, I like to make my Play-Doh sparkle. So I've got some biodegradable glitter, which I'm gonna put in my Play-Doh today. There's all our ingredients. Now we're ready to get cooking. Today's arts and crafts involves some heat on a hot plate, so you will need a parent or guardian's permission or supervision in order to complete this craft. Let's get cooking. Okay, so all you have to do to begin is to put all of your ingredients into a mixing bowl, and you do need something to mix it with. So I'm just slowly adding my water a little bit at a time, just so I'm not sloshing it all around onto my table. And you mix, 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 mix until it's all combined. Now it kind of looks a little bit like Play-Doh, but really I think all it is right now is very salty cake batter. Do not eat this. It's got way too much salt for consumption. All right, now I want to make a few different colors. So I've got some little mixing bowls to separate out my mixture so that I can have more than one color. Okay, so I've separated out my batter into four roughly equal portions. Now I'm gonna pick my colors. I think I want some pink. Whoops. That's gonna be quite pink. So when you're adding your food dye, don't do what I just did and just pour a whole heap in there. Do one drop at a time because food dye actually is very deceiving. The color goes a long way. Okay, this has been part one of a two-part series entitled What Are Bones? If you would like to know how to finish this Anatomy, Arts and Crafts, then tune in because the next episode is part two.